In this illustration, we'll analyze a freely moving rod on a horizontal plane. Here we are given that on a smooth horizontal plane, a thin uniform rod of length L is placed. One end of rod is given an impulse in direction normal to it. And we are required to find the displacement of center of mass of rod by the time it completes one rotation. Here in solution, we can draw the figure that a rod is placed on a smooth horizontal plane and it is of length L. And one end of the rod is given an impulse in direction normal to it. So, if an impulse J is imparted onto one end, say the rod is AB, and at an A, an impulse J is imparted. So, due to this J, center of mass will attain a velocity VC and it starts rotating at an angular speed omega C. As we know, free body always rotate about an axis passing through center of mass. So, here we can use impulse momentum equation as for linear motion, we can write here J is equals to MVC. That is our first equation, which is giving us the value of velocity of center of mass, that is J by M. And we can write for angular motion, the angular impulse imparted is J multiplied by L by 2, and that should be equals to M L square by 12 multiplied by omega C. That is our equation 2, which is giving us the value of omega C, which we are getting as 6 J upon ML. Now, in this situation, this is the angular speed with which the rod starts rotating and this is the linear speed of center of mass. So, here if we calculate the time of one rotation of rod, then here we can directly write this time is equals to 2 pi by omega c. And here we substitute the value of omega c over here, this gives us pi ml divided by 3j. And in this time, we wish to calculate the displacement of center of mass, then we can write displacement of center of mass in above time is, this s we can write as vct. And Vc we have calculated as J by M multiplied by the time is pi ML by 3J. So here J and M gets cancelled out and the value of this displacement we are getting is pi L by 3. That is the result of this problem.